Hey folks, Eric here from DirtyLittleSneakers.com, and I am psyched to talk to you today about the Polar Vantage V. This is the first watch that Polar has launched, the Vantage series, I should say, not just the V, there's also the M, that actually looks like a watch and not just a sport watch. It's the first watch you can wear out in public and not be seen, you know, like this. I'm gonna go out for one more run, and then I'm gonna come back to you. I'm gonna talk to you about what I like, what I don't like, and all that kind of stuff. All right. Hang in there.
2 hours later.
Thanks again for tuning in. I want you to know if you're looking for the Polar Vantage V, I have put a link below that goes to my Amazon associate account. Know that I do get a couple shekels if you use that link to buy the watch. Just goes to fund the channel, so I'd appreciate it if you would use that link if you are so inclined. All right, let's get to the review. So I've been training with the Vantage V for about, I don't know, 2 weeks I want to say now. There are definitely some positives and negatives about the watch. Let's talk about the positives first. I love the design. I love the buttons. I love the feel of it. I think that the material that they made the strap out of is phenomenal. It just looks like a classy watch. It's great. It's great. There's no flaws in the design at all. What did take me a little bit of getting used to was the way that the menus are structured. Menus go left to right as opposed to up and down. I'll show you what that means in a little B-roll. I'm used to Garmin, which goes up and down. So it's not a positive, it's not a negative. It's just is. It took me a little bit of while to get used to that. Some of the features that I really like about this, the training load indicator, they say it takes about a month for it to figure out your habits and your workout schedule. I found that it was pretty easily within a week. It had figured out exactly where I needed to be, when I should be training, when I was overtraining, when I was undertraining. Recovery monitor. This is something that you get in some of the higher level other products, the recovery monitor. The Polar Flow, which is there, it's the Polar website, but it also uploads to Strava or Training Peaks or MapMyRun or any of the other third party websites that you want to upload to. They like Polar Flow. Polar Flow has some interesting statistics that you can get for free. I'll put up a screenshot of what it looks like. So I liked Polar Flow, but I'm a creature of habit and I like using what I'm used to. So I was uploading everything to Strava and sort of looking at some statistics there. I use a third party on Strava as well that I can get into in another review. It estimates your VO2 max, and I found that it was estimating exactly what my other device was estimating. So right or wrong, it's spot on with what's out there in the industry. Thousands of sport profiles. I'm always floored by the amount of sport profiles that that Polar has on their devices. You can see I'm gonna scroll through what I used for the M430, I think it was. I mean, it's just an amazing array that you can put all of them on your, I mean, if you do all of them, maybe you don't. You put all of them on your watch and you can scroll through and you can choose any one of them to do at any time. At the end of a workout, it gives you a training benefit. That is whether the training was beneficial or whether you're, whether it's hurting you. So good statistics to have. Did have continuous HRM, which is you have to set on the watch, which I like because I like to see where my heart rate is spiking during the day. And lastly, it does sleep tracking. Now, I found that on the sleep tracking, some nights it tracked my sleep and some nights it didn't track my sleep. So I'm not really sure why that was, but sometimes it didn't upload, and when I tried to re-upload, it didn't. So the sleep tracking data wasn't there. One of the other things that I think is phenomenal about this, and I think that other watch manufacturers need to start adopting this, is that you can change the data sets that you're looking at while you were in an activity from the app. That is, you don't have to scroll through a myriad of different data points on your watch to figure out what you wanna show when and where. You set it in the app on your phone, you sync it to the watch, and you're done. This is, I don't know why everyone hasn't adopted this method. It saves so much time, and I love it. I would buy this watch just for that feature. So some of the things that I didn't like is, for the price that you pay for this, I feel like you should be able to customize the menus and the widgets that you're looking at. That is not to say the data pieces that you're looking at while you're doing an activity, but what is in the menu. So am I gonna have my VO2 max along with my steps for a day, or I can't pick and choose what I wanna see. It's all there. I gotta scroll through it if I wanna get to the data pieces that I wanna see. But again, for the price that you're paying for this watch, you should be able to customize that aspect. The fact that you can't auto-sync, I noticed that at the end of the day, I would have to manually sync the watch to my phone in order to get all of the data onto Polar Flow or to Strava or to wherever else I was gonna be uploading to, or you're uploading to. Again, for the price, like, I don't understand why it's just a simple auto-upload to the website. It's a no-brainer. The other thing is the fact that I only have two options for watch face, analog or digital. And maybe I'm spoiled by Garmin and Garmin Connect IQ, but I like to be able to choose what I want to see on the watch face, and I don't want it to be just digital or analog. Oh, one of the things that I really liked about this is that the crystal is really clear. I could see it very easily on my run or my swim. I gotta say that, you know, as I'm getting older, I'm wearing glasses. I don't wear my glasses when I run, so I like a watch that's really clear and really bright, and I found that the Polar was perfect in that respect. So I give it a thumbs up. I think that there's some great positives to this watch. There's some great negatives to this watch. If you're in the Polar universe, this is definitely gonna be a great upgrade for you. All right, folks, if you like this video, smash that like button below. Get it up the YouTube algorithm a little bit more. If you like gear reviews, race reviews, or anything during sports related, I am your guy. Please smash that subscribe button, but more importantly, the bell next to it, so you get notified when I put up new videos just about every week or so. And thanks for tuning in. I'll see you next time.